The purpose of this video is to explain to you how to do an informed consent, okay? So there's two documents that you can find in the syllabus, hyperlinks in the syllabus. The first is the informed consent instructions, and the other one is an informed consent template. It's sort of a specific example so you know what it looks like. The first two pieces of information that it's really important for you to know is the informed consent means that we give people information about the research study that we're trying to conduct. And then the second part is that participants with this information, they can choose to consent to participate in the research study. So those are two key, very important things that happen in that order. People are informed, and then they provide their consent. And so the purpose of the informed consent document is to give them all that information in writing. So this is all the information that you want to provide. So you want to know what the title of the project is, the principal investigator, and in this case, that would be you. Sometimes we'll have a faculty mentor, and so in that case, it would be whoever your faculty member is. And then you want to be clear that you're inviting them to participate in the study. It is not mandatory. They are not required. You are invited to participate in the study. In order to participate, you must be blankety blank. And so that is your population, the eligibility criteria, or the inclusion criteria. So who are you going to include in the study and why? So one easy inclusion criteria might be, you know, if you want to study depression, then it might be people with depression, right? So you want to include people in the study that may have depression so you can sort of see how you can fix that depression, right? Also, you want to include exclusion criteria. So who are you going to exclude in the study? Who may not participate? So an easy one would be, say, a child. You do not want a six-year-old participating in this study. Now, you may want to do research with children, and that's fine, but then you need to get parental consent. Either way, it's all described here. The other things is that you want to give them some important information about the study. So the purpose of the study, blank, blank, blank. And so here is where you put in your purpose statement for the research. And we do have a week that we talk about what the purpose statement is and how to write it. And so that's where you put it in there. This will approximately take, you know, if they're filling out questions, right? And this goes based on your measurement tool. So how long would it take someone to fill out that measurement tool? And actually now we don't really use 10 to 20 minutes. We might say like 3 to 5 minutes. That's how long it should take. What are risks or discomforts that people could experience as they participate in the study? One of the other things you need to look at is the level of IRB review, which we'll talk about that in another video. But let's see what else. This is voluntary. We want to be very clear that it's voluntary. What is the study about? Why are we doing it? What will happen if you take part of the study? How could you benefit from the study? What risks? That's sort of duplication. And then they give examples, like primary risk could be physical, psychological, information risks. The other thing too is the IRB levels of risk. It's minimal, it's less than minimal risk, minimal risk, or more than minimal risk. Those are the only three categories. We're going to talk about how we're going to protect your information from, you know, we're not going to publish this information. You also want to be clear about, is this information confidential or anonymous? And there are differences, so know the differences before you decide. Is this project funded? Your projects are most likely not funded by anything. What happens to your information when the study is over? How will we compensate you? Most likely you're not going to compensate them in any way. Sometimes people provide incentives. So a question for you to reflect on is, what were the incentives provided in the Felizzi article? So they did provide participants incentives. Does this cost? No, there's no cost for people to participate in your study. Who can profit from the results? Most likely no one. No one can profit from these results of the research. Again, your participation is voluntary. The PI is the principal investigator. And again, that's you. And you are required to put down your name, email, phone, and address. Actually, it doesn't say address here, but you are required to put down an address. Now, you could put the school address, but you are required to put down an address. And when you are a student, you also have to put down the faculty mentor. So whoever your professor is for the class, they would be your faculty mentor. The other thing that you need to put down is whoever the IRB is that is going to approve your study. And because you are at Millersville, you will use the Millersville IRB. Now, this says University of Michigan, but you want to look up Millersville's information, the Millersville IRB board. An IRB board stands for Institutional Review Board. So you want to look up Millersville's address, phone number, and who is in charge of the IRB at Millersville. And then they provide their consent. And so they sign here. Okay, so these are all the instructions. You can, and then, but what I would encourage you to do is, because this is 9 pages, your informed consent should only be like 1 to 2 pages. It shouldn't be that long. So I would encourage you to go and look at the template, and that will give you an idea of a specific example.